When the Pharisees went out and laid plans to trap him in his words, they sent their disciples to him along with the Herodians. "Teacher," they said, "we know you are a man of integrity and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. You aren't swayed by men because you pay no attention to who they are. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" But Jesus, knowing their evil intent, said, "You hypocrites, why are you trying to trap me? Show me the coin used for paying the tax." They brought him a denarius, and they asked him, "Whose portrait is this, and whose inscription?" "Caesar's," they replied. Then he said to them, "Give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's." When they heard this, they were amazed. So they left him and went away. Now, obviously, this is talking about the taxes and the Pharisees trying to trap Jesus. But out of these seven scriptures, the one that struck me was, "You aren't swayed by men because you pay no attention to who they are." Now, this is the Pharisees recognizing that Jesus is not swayed by man's opinion.
Amen. That's a good word.
Now, they're trying to trap him.
Yes.
With their evil hearts. But they still recognize you aren't swayed by men.
Amen.
This struck me so because what generation is this? Everyone says, why can't we just get along? This is the coexist, accept anything and everything generation.
Hello.
Well, you can't say that because I'm offended. The offended generation, my opinion is only the opinion that matters.
Hello. Amen.
It's the watered down, lukewarm church that Jesus warns us about.
Yes.
No one will stand that line. John 15:18 says, "If the world hates you, keep in mind they hated me first."
Amen.
So church, we've got to get it out of our heads that we're all just going to get along.
That's right.
Amen.
We've got to stand for Jesus. The Bible says stand firm. I looked it up one time. I believe it's 22 times. God's warning us to stand firm. Now, if he's telling us 22 times in the Bible,
stand firm.
Stand firm,
wow.
Child of God.
Wow.
Stand firm, church.
Amen.
It's because he knows it's an issue.
Amen.
He knows there's compromise.
Yes.
Compromise has slipped into the church. Compromise has slipped into the body disguised as love.
Good word.
Disguised as love.
Thank you.
Well, we love people. Of course we love people.
Yes.
Jesus loved them. He didn't love their sin.
Yes.
Repent, world. Repent, church. I'm going to read from Matthew 10:34. "Do not suppose," this is Jesus talking, so once again, it's important. "Do not suppose that I have come to bring peace on earth. I did not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to turn a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies will be of their own household." Now, does this sound like can't we all just get along?
No. Not at all.
A man's enemies will be members of his own household. How often do we talk to people that are steeped in religion?
Amen.
Steeped in religious traditions.
Yes.
And when you really start talking to someone, but here's the issue, church, nobody wants to talk to anybody because they might offend.
That's right.
Number one, you got to know the word to talk to someone.
Oh, my.
Come on.
You got to know the word to be confident in talking to someone. People are steeped in religion. How many times have we talked about because mom did it, because grandma did it, because great-grandma did it?
Yes.
Baptists, Catholics, Methodists, all across the board, you talk to people, they don't even know why they're going to church. I decided I'm going to do a sermon on, I want to just do a poll with coworkers, with friends, with whatever. I'm going to ask them one question. Why do you go to church?
Come on.
Yeah.
Because I don't think most people know why they're supposed to go to church.
Amen.
They go to church because mama goes, because grandma goes, because we just go and then we go eat. Because we go because, well, I feel good and that's what I'm supposed to do. Well, I look good in the community. Well, I'm on city council, so I need to be in the big Baptist church on the corner so they can see me every Sunday. I don't think most people even know why they're supposed to be in church. Many people go to feel good.
Right. Amen.
They go and they want to feel good on Sunday. And they leave because they got cotton candy and milk. And they leave the same. They may feel good, but they know nothing about the word. They know nothing about what God expects them to do. So, church, get it out of your heads. Everyone's not going to love us. We're all just not going to get along. And when you start opening your mouth and speaking truth, people are going to get offended. They're going to get mad. They're going to get upset because they don't really know what the word says and they don't want to know. They don't want to know.
Amen. Amen.
I think many, many people do not read the Bible because they don't really want to know what it says.
Because that is right.
Because if you know what it says, then you're going to have to change.
You're accountable.
Then you know.
Amen.
Years ago, when we first started going to this church, have a seat, please. I'm sorry. When we first started going to this church, Pastor said, and I didn't understand it at first, he said, y'all can do things that I can't. And I didn't understand that, because to me, sin is sin. I'm like, well, if I can do it, he can't do it. That makes no sense. And now I understand it. Because as God shows you, as you open God's word, as you get the revelation,
yeah,
as you start to understand, then you're held accountable because you know.
Yes.
Because you know. When I'm witnessing to people at work, wherever, and I talk to them, and I'm telling them something, you can tell they do not want to know.
That is so true. Amen.
And I tell them, I'll say, here's the thing, now you're accountable. Now you will not be able to stand in front of our God and say, no one told you.
Amen.
And I put it that clear. I said,
amen,
I'm telling you. You're not going to be able to say, God didn't tell me.
Amen.
I didn't know. I'm telling
you
now.
Thank you.
See, God will send someone to tell everyone, just like they send pastor and other people to tell us.
Amen.
It's the growing up.
Amen.
It's the growing up.
Amen.
No one wants to grow up. They want to go to church on Sunday. They want to feel good. They want to go, oh, that was nice. That was nice. And that's it. And like Pastor talks about, you've got Christians that have been sitting in church 10, 20, 30 years, spiritually are toddlers. In their diapers, walking around. They don't know how to fight. They read maybe one time they're supposed to be a warrior. And talking about the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt of truth, the shield of faith, the sword is the word, and you shod your feet with the shoes of the gospel. They may have heard that one time, but they don't understand that it is real.
Right.
God gave us the armor for the battle.
Yes.
We are in a battle, child of God. A spiritual battle every single day.
Amen.
The
Amen.
Enemy wants to kill, steal, and destroy.
Yes.
Now, he can do that many ways, many, many ways. But compromise is a big one that slips right into the church. It slips right into the body of Christ. And I may have talked about this a couple of weeks ago. I can't remember. But about the woman that Pastor Tony talked to, that she said she was a Christian and she went to church every Sunday, yet she still believed in reincarnation and wanted to know about aliens. This is how weak the body is.
Aliens are demons in the flesh.
Yeah. This is how weak the body is.
Yes.
Same thing. I was talking to a woman the other day I'm witnessing to, and she says, yes, I'm saved, absolutely, I love the Lord. But I used to go ghost hunting, and I've seen apparitions, and so she said this a couple times. It's in a Bible study group, and I said, stop. I said, those are demons. So every time she said the word ghost or apparition, stop. Call it what it is.
Amen.
It is a demon.
Amen.
You saw. It is a demon you are seeking out.
Yes.
So, child of God, when you're going to the haunted houses and the ghost hunting and all of this mess that they've got, and people, I see Christian after Christian after Christian going down that road. Well, I just want to see something. It'll be fun. It'll be a girls' weekend. And they have no idea what they're playing with. Have no idea what they're playing with. The body of Christ is so incredibly weak right now.
Yes.
And I say all that, 2 Corinthians 6:17, wherefore come out from among them and separate, says the Lord. Do not touch anything unclean, and he will receive you.
Hallelujah.
Come out and be separate. That does not say, yes, I'm going to get along, I'm going to have lots and lots of friends because I don't want to offend.
Or be relevant.
Child of God, you have to settle this in your heart. Pastor told us years ago, the higher you climb with the Lord, the more friends you're going to lose. And that is absolutely true. You have lots and lots of friends. If you're going to the club, or you're having Super Bowl parties, you're drinking, whatever you're doing, you have a lot of friends. And the minute you start stopping all that stuff, the friends stop.
Yes.
They don't want to be around you anymore.
Yes.
They don't want to hear that Jesus stuff. You now convict them. Christ in you convicts them. Oh, well, we can't say anything around them. Well, praise God.
Thank God we're making a stand.
Praise God. Praise God. And how it saddens me greatly at the weak, compromised church. The weak, compromised body that believes in aliens, reincarnation, ghost hunting, horoscopes, all acupuncture, all of this mess that you are putting your faith in an instrument instead of God. In a creation instead of the Creator.
Amen.
Too many people want to believe and they think, oh, it's nothing. No, it's something to God. That's what people miss. Even the little things, which I'm constantly talking to coworkers about, the foul mouth. Oh, well, it's just cussing. Really, it's not a big deal. Well, God thinks it's a big deal.
Yes.
So people want to just water down the word, not read the word, not understand the word, do what they want to do, and then be effective. Be able to call themselves Christian when they act nothing like it. I say all this just to say, quit trying to just get along. Speak truth, speak Jesus. You're going to lose friends, but hallelujah, we're going to get to see our Father one day.
Amen.
And what do we want? We want to hear,
well done.
Well done. Hallelujah. Thank
you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise you.